How we doing, everyone? Welcome to this episode of Fishing with G. This is part 5 of my session at Rainbow. Keeping these videos nice and short and bite-sized. So it is now Wednesday morning, and it's first thing in the morning. It has literally just got light, and you join a bit of a grumpy G on the banks of Rainbow in Peg 19, I'm afraid. For those people that have been following the vlogs before this, the other 4 parts, you'll know that I've been doing really well. I've had 9 fish out so far, up to 60 pounds. But it's gone a little bit slow over the last 24 hours, just a couple of bites. But my banker rod is my right-hand rod over there, which is going up against the island. Now that seems to be doing a bite on first light every day. Now I had a bream on my long rod at 4 o'clock in the morning, and I actually sat up after that drinking tea, thinking that rod's gonna go soon. It got light and it hadn't gone. I was so tired. I laid in my bed, and literally as soon as I had closed my eyes, the alarm went, the rod hooped over. Now I'm fishing these real tight, locked up really tight. And the tip went over, slammed over like this, and the drag was actually going. It was like a screamer against a tight clutch. And I mean a clutch that's almost cutting into my hands with the braid when I pull it, it's that tight. And it was taking line off of it, which, to be honest with you, I think is normally a sign of one of the smaller fish inside here, say smaller, like 30s or 40s or something, not one of the real big girls. They tend to be sort of slower, ploddy takes. But anyway, went down to the rod, lifted into it. Now, when I lift into this one, let me come over to it. Here we go. Let me show you what I'm about. Here it is here, just on the point, and it's going out there to the island, and I'm up against a snag on the island. So when I hit into it, I've got to move back like this, and I've got to go back as quick as I can and pull that fish away from the snag. However, something went wrong this morning, and it's actually gone wrong with one of the other takes that I've had on this rod as well, but I managed to get that fish in. And that is that I am absolutely loving these R4 alarms, right? The homecoming function is mint. I went out last night, you just press on the receiver, the homecoming, and all your lights light up on the back of the alarms and you can come back to shore. Like, that is a proper safety feature. However, the one thing that I don't like about these alarms are the snag ears. And it's nothing technical, but it's the snag ears. Because if I just show you this, if you have a look at the snag ears, they've got this lip on them, this ridge. And then what happened was, is that where I've lifted the rod up and I've had to go back this way, when you lift the rod up, the line, I've taken this snag ear off now, but the line catches on that snag ear. So what happened was, is that I'm lifting the rod up and going this way, trying to pull the fish back, but the line's caught on that snag ear. So I've had to go back to the alarm, unhook it from the snag ear, then come back this way. And just in that split second of having to go back there and get the line out of that that snag ear, the fish has just taken me a little bit further into the snag and it got snagged up there, and I had to go out in the boat to try and rescue it. I got out in the boat and you could see my hook was actually on some old braid that was inside the snag, just sort of hanging there. So although I am pissed off, don't get me wrong, I've lost a fish from Rainbow. However, I haven't left a hook in it, I've not left it training any line, I've not left a snag in the water, and I actually managed to clear that snag in the process as well. So, you know, I feel good that that fish is not going to come to any harm from that experience at all. But yeah, you can see I've unscrewed one of those snag ears now on that side. I should have done it from the start. My mistake. And I will learn from that. I won't fish the 2 snag ears. I'll just fish the 1 if I am looking to strike to the side and run to the side. But anyway, that's enough of me griping. I've lost 1, I've had 9. Hey, I'm at Rainbow. And for those people that have watched the rest of the series, Nick is fishing on my left-hand side. I'm fishing on the right-hand side of 19. As I say, I've had 9 fish so far. It is Wednesday morning. It's such a magical place, this. Such a magical place. It was so quiet last night. All the stars were out. There's a big full moon. I was out there placing my baits, and I think I redid them again. I had 2 bream last night, actually. I redid them at midnight, and I redid them at 5 o'clock in the morning. Each time I went out in the boat, it was just star-covered skies, big moon shining down. I didn't even need my torch out there. It was awesome, flat calm as well. Such an amazing experience, such an amazing experience. And that is why I love going fishing. I'm sure that a lot of you out there can relate to that. It's about being out in nature and completely switching off. So yeah, that's enough of me waffling on anyway. And in fact, actually talking about switching off, I've actually made a decision to come away from social media. So I'm still gonna keep my YouTube channels going,
But social media, I'm going to just have a little break from it, because what I've noticed is that whilst I've been here in this peg, in this beautiful surrounding, you know, immersed with nature, I am constantly scrolling on my phone, and I don't want to be. You know, when I actually think about it and I reflect, I don't want to be sat there scrolling on my phone. I want to be looking at the lizards. I want to be listening to the birds. I want to be, you know, watching for fish jumping and rolling. I want to be present and mindful. And being a development tutor for a lot of my life, and, you know, now being very aware of the mental health benefits of angling and being mindful, I just found that I was sitting here and I was like, hang on a minute. I'm not mindful. I'm not present. I'm not in the moment here. I'm, you know, living someone else's life through social media, or I'm replying to messages and stuff of people that I don't know. So you'll be still be able to follow my fishing journeys on YouTube. You can still drop comments and get in touch with me on YouTube. If you have got my number and stuff, my WhatsApp number, by all means, give me a phone call, people, my friends out there. Give me a call from time to time. But I'm going to have a little break from social media. I think it'll be good for my mental health, good for my family life. And it's much needed. And it also means I can focus more on doing these beautiful videos for you guys out there, because this is like my way of diarizing my life, basically, of fishing. So I'm gonna keep doing these ones as if it was my journal and my diary. Regardless of how many people watch them, I enjoy doing them. So anyway, that's me waffling on. It's Wednesday morning. Let's see if we can catch a fish for you on this fifth installment in this series in Peg 19. I hope you're enjoying it. Remember, do subscribe. Do slap a thumbs up on this video as well. And let's see if we can have another rainbow chunk today.
What have you got here, Nick?
Not a great deal. Not a great deal.
Well, it's a giant chub.
He's a giant chub.
Ah, nice.
But it's off one of your rods, off one of your little snag rods.
That's all right, mate.
Here we go, a little nice little grass carp.
Exactly, a bit of action for you, mate. That's all good.
Yeah. Here we go.
Lift her up for a little pic, shall we?
Let's lift her up
for a little video. A
little bit of a video.
They're like torpedoes, aren't they, these things?
Big chub.
Big chub, monster chub. Get the roll in a bit of meat under the snag bushes, that might help. Oh, well done, mate, good.
There we go. Not nice, even going to weigh it.
Well done, bud.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Wednesday afternoon, enjoying me out in the boat doing battle with a bow carp. We've had two fish this morning off this spot, and this is the third bite. Just plodding around. Not really doing much this one. She is. Not the biggest one from Bow, but still another carp. Whee! Yep. Ooh-hoo. This is what you look forward to when you go to Bow. Epic boat battles. Oh. See the ST13 with that progressive power bend in it actually works really nicely. On a fast tippy action rod, I'd be scared stiff doing this, but they've got such a lot of power, and they're lovely rods, these. is yabba-dabba-doo. Yes, get in. So we need to be on those Denny Fairbrass, isn't it? Yes, get in there. Not a big one, but they are all fun at Bow. All right, break the rod in two, so it's easy to get back. I'm gonna try and unhook this one in the net, take it back to shore, and we're going to see it back and back. Oh, in fact, actually, what may I show you now? There she is, sitting in the net. Oop.
Hard fighting, rainbow common.
Well, there we go, £29 this one, just a little rainbow baby, but a real nice looking one. I think it's a male fish, this one. Probably been trying to chase those big fat females around by the island, so we will slip him back. But before we do, let's just hold him up for the camera. There you go. I know a lot of people would just be slipping these back off the net, but I don't know, you go to all this effort to come to Rainbow and catch fish. I like to put a weight on all of them, so thank you very much. Big or small, we love them all. Back you go, girl. Well, it's just gone 1 o'clock in the afternoon on Wednesday, and around here
in the water, da, 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 da. There we go.
That is, I think that's the 1, 2, 3, 4th bite, I think, this morning from that spot. So yeah, it seems to be revving back up again, that right hand spot, because I went 24 hours without a bite on it on Tuesday, I think it was. So seems to be working, putting a little bit more bait over the spot and then going back to fishing the little pop-ups over the top. And so far, I don't want to say it too loud, but no bream yet. So yeah, it seems to be working. But this one is rather interesting because I was playing it in the boat. When I first saw it, I thought I got a common carp. And then I saw it again, and it was fighting on the surface quite a lot. And I thought, do you know what? I've got a fully. I've got a fully from Rainbow. And now I've got it in the sling. I don't know what it is, to be honest. Nick doesn't know what it is either. We don't know, do we, Nick? What is it?
It's a weird one.
It's a fomen.
It's a crossbred.
it's a rainbow fomen carp. That's what we're going to call it. So we're going to get it and bring it out. And maybe you at home, you can say, do you think this is a fully, like, or a common? If it is a fully, it's like the most... I can't even explain it. You'll see it in a minute. You'll see it in a minute. Right, let's go get it out and show you this fomen. We need to have someone that's sort of like an expert on the matter. Right, so what do you say there, Nick?
That's looking common.
That's looking common. I agree. That's looking common. But then if we do this...
Abracadabra.
on there, these ones, I suppose, I don't know. These ones are all sort of like these like mirror scales, all mishmashed around on that side. I don't know. Come around this side and have a little look at it from over my shoulder, Nick.
I think we can call that a common.
I think it's got to be a common, isn't it?
I think that could be a battle scar or some description.
Yeah, battle scar there. Oh, on the top there. They're sort of all, they're out of uniform, aren't they, on the top there? That's why it looked like a fully when I got it, when it was fighting, but like, oh, you're right. I think you've got a bit of a run-in with something when you were younger, haven't you? And that chunk out of you is a fully, and then that the rest of you is a common. So you are a common, you're just a rather unusual one. All right.
Battle scarred
common. Right, let's get on the scales then and see what she weighs. I reckon probably about 32, I reckon.
Ooh.
35, 12 we go with on that one. 35. Hey, what are you doing, Nick? You're making it bigger.
Well, I'll try to spin it around for the camera, but it's not.
What is it? Let's have a look. 35, 12 I'll go on that one. What's a few ounces between friends, eh? Right, let's go and get a few pictures of this one, put it back. But yeah, let us know, what do you reckon? Common or fully? Common or fully? Here she is. The rainbow foreman. we go. I don't know what happened like that. But yeah, you can see why when I was fighting her, she, even on that side there, if I turn around, you see those scales at the top, Nick? She's, yeah, funny thing. But thank you very much.
Oh!
Yeah. Gets deep there, Nick.
Almost. That'll be a classic.
Well, they don't do you've been framed anymore, do they? Hey, show my age there. There you go, foreman. Thank you very much. Right, let's get back on the spot, see if we get another one. Right, welcome to my bait kitchen. For today's lunch, we're gonna be making some tarted up trigger ice. So this is basically what I've been doing, is washing out the baits, making them nice and soft. It's something I do for most of my fishing, to be honest with you. So I'm just gonna take some of the trigger ice shelf lives. I've got a bucket over here of some lake water. So I'm just gonna pop those in the lake water. Like so. And then we have got some of the liquid booster, that one there. And what I'm gonna do is just take a dose of that. I'll probably put about a third of a bottle in. There we go, there we are, about that. And then I'm gonna give that a shake and a stir. So just put the lid on. Give it. Just like this. And what that does, it'll take on the water, take on that liquid booster. And yeah, just helps to soften the baits up. They're quite soft anyway, because they're steamed, the baits. But you can see there, the way that the liquid booster is actually taken into the water there, and then the baits will just sit inside them, taking all that juice. And I've just poured the rest of that juice over the spot as well. So that liquid, I won't waste that. I'll actually pour that in as a liquid attractant over the spots as well. So that there, we let that brew for a few hours, and then I'll use that tonight. And I'm going through around about 6-7 kilos a day, I think, which sounds a lot, but when you're doing four rods, you know, it's a couple of kilos per rod per day is what we're using over at the moment. So not too much bait for rainbow standards at all. Just enough to get a bite and just enough to get the fish visiting the spots. Right, well, that's that. Let's go and put the rods out and see if we can catch another fish. Well, it's definitely been a productive day today. Keep me on my toes. I've got a just under 28 pound common here. Let's just pop that one back. But none of the big girls today. Oh, let's pull that down. Yeah, none of the big girls. Not sure where they are, I'm on pest control. Well, you can probably see by the light levels that it's evening time now on Wednesday. We've just had the, Nick said, and it's raining as well. It's been a pretty miserable afternoon, if I'm honest with you. Although we're still having fun and enjoying it, but yeah, the sunshine and shorts weather is long gone, it looks like, and we've been met with cold winds, rain coming in, and yeah, sort of more carpy weather really. But it's been a good day bite wise. We had 6 bites, none of them big though. Nick had a grass carp on my rods. I think the biggest we've had is 35 pound, I think, today. Which is still, you know, a good sized fish, but not really what you come to Rainbow for. But 6 bites in a day, that's good going. I've got another fish in the net, so that's number 6. And we're going to have a little look at it. Gave me a really, really good boat battle out there. I keep wanting to take you guys out with me on my head and do a boat battle. But the thing is the takes are so violent and you've got your rods all strapped down and stuff that unless I'm walking around a swim wearing my camera on my head, looking like an upright plonker, I just haven't got the time to go and grab the camera and get ready before I go out and stuff. But hopefully by the end of this series, I will get a battle on camera. But let's go on over, have a little look. There we go, there's the old boat with my very carpy orange life jacket on there. I'll see if I can shed a bit of light on the situation. And skulking in the net there, it's like a two-tone common. There she is. Your two-tone on her? There you go, two-tone common. So we'll go and get that weighed, get some water shots with her, and I'll put the rod back out. And yeah, hopefully one of the big, big girls turns up tonight. All right, you're pointing at me. Crack on. Let me turn this off. Right, okay, moment of truth. She's in the sling. I've got no idea how big this one's going to be honest. She's quite thick, but not that long. Let's have a little look. I think she might go over 40. What are we saying, Nick? Yeah, she does, doesn't she?
43.
43 and a half. Wicked.
Yeah.
43 and a half, two-tone common. Right. Let's get some photos. Try and get the rod back out before it goes dark. Right, so here she is. Fish number 6 of the day. The two-tone common. 43 and a half pounds. Oh, 43 and a half pound of two-tone rainbow common. That's bite number 6 of the day. Look at that lovely fish. There we go. Got a really good scrap this one. Thank you very much. Mwah. Put you back to where your home is for you to go big into one of those big 70 pounders. Good stuff. Right, well, I think that's a good point now to stop this part 5. We're now getting into darkness, so next time you see us, we'll either be in the middle of the night or tomorrow morning. But please do remember to subscribe and like the videos, and I'll put a link up here or down there to the previous parts of this episode on Peg 19 at Rainbow Lake. But hopefully you're enjoying this. I'm gonna put the rods out. Catch you all soon.